Play Vettel shows fight with stunning Mexico pole 108. Sebastian Vettel refused to let Lewis Hamilton's lead in the title race deter him as he claimed pole in Mexico, 1,081,151 PM BST. ESPN rounds up all the reaction from up and down the Autódromo Hermanos Rodríguez paddock following qualifying for the Mexican Grand Prix. Mercedes Sutton image. Lewis Hamilton third pole position was the goal today, but at WASNT meant to be. It was a difficult session and I think it was a difficult weekend overall. It is very slippery here and some of the issues we have with the car are a little bit highlighted by that. I gave it everything I had, but the gap to the front was too big. Our long run pace is definitely better than our qualifying pace, so I'm not worried about that. But you need a big delta to overtake here, so track position is important. It is a long way down to turn one, so we should have some fun tomorrow. I'm hoping I'm able to move forward at the start. Afterwards it should be a one-stop strategy. The crowd looks incredible, there's a lot of energy. It's such a spectacle from above, I saw the camera from the helicopter. So winning here on Mexican soil would be pretty neat. Valtteri Bottas fourth hour qualifying WASNT good enough, we thought we could fight for the pole. We definitely struggled a bit compared to at least one of the Ferraris and one of the Red Bulls, for some reason they found quite a bit of lap time for Q3. The incident with Max ruined my first lap in Q3, I just couldn't get back to the normal line for braking. However, I'm still optimistic for the race. We had good long runs yesterday and we'll have a strong car tomorrow. As a team, we're starting from the second row, and it's such a long run into turn one here. Hopefully we can have a good start and use the slipstream to our advantage. It should be an interesting race. Toto Wolff, head of Mercedes-Benz Motorsport. First of all, congratulations to Sebastian on a very impressive pole position. We have locked out the second row this afternoon and, to be honest, I'm reasonably satisfied with that. We knew that it would be difficult for us here, running at a high downforce circuit, so the result is okay. With that in mind, it feels like we have taken a step forward in these conditions compared to recent races. There were big gaps between teammates today, so it is nice to see our drivers so close together, especially as Valtteri only had one opportunity to set a time in Q3. That shows he is bouncing back in the right way from a difficult run of races. Now we have to look forward to a long race tomorrow. Lewis had a promising long run during second practice, so there are still plenty of opportunities open for us to take. Red Bull photo credit should read Yuri Cortez of BGT image. Max Verstappen second, another front row qualification, so I am pretty satisfied with today's result. Q2 was really good, but somehow we lost a bit in Q3 with the tires, I couldn't get them to work and struggled for grip. I would say the Q3 lap was better, but I just didn't have the grip from the previous session. The plan was to abort the first lap in both sessions and use that as a build lap. At the end of the day we are still second and on the front row, so no big issue. It is always nice to get a pole position, but winning the race is more important. I am confident in the race pace of the car and that we can achieve a good result, but we still have to show this tomorrow. Starting on the front row with such a long run into turn one means we can hopefully get away well and ahead. We are usually quicker in the race than qualifying, so I am excited for tomorrow. Daniel Ricciardo seventh, we have been strong all weekend, but in qualifying we just didn't have any grip. I topped the times in FP2 and Max did the same this morning, so we didn't really touch the car from yesterday, but every time I left the pits today I just had no grip. We tried experimenting in Q3 and doing an extra warm-up lap to try and give the tires something extra, but it seemed that the grip I had when I left the box was the grip I had until the end of each run. Sometimes you get one set of tires that you can't turn on or warm up properly and you might lose some time, but every run it seemed to be the same story. This morning the track was really cold and we were still able to post a time on the first lap, so it should have been a breeze to get the tires up to temperature this afternoon. If we can get the car back to what we had before qualifying, then I think we can still fight for a podium tomorrow, but this is confusing and we really need to understand what happened in the last hour. Ferrari photo by Clive Mason. Getty image. Sebastian Vettel. Obviously I am really happy. I had a perfect lap in the end, even if the track here is difficult and very slippery. It is easy to make mistakes going over the limit here. But I thought to myself that if I could get T1 right, then I'd have a better chance. The last sector was also tricky because you know how easily you can go wide and lose a lot of time, but I managed to push and stay clean. So, I am really happy, especially because other cars were close and it's nice to hold everybody off. Yesterday the car was not where we wanted to be, but today everything was okay, and I think tomorrow we'll be quick enough. Let's see what happens at the start, and after that, we should have a good race. I know it's a long way to turn one, but overall I am confident because our starts are good. Last weekend it was tough for the whole team because it went through a lot of work and a lot of changes. This weekend has been better. I think we deserve to get the result today and hope to have a great race tomorrow. Kimi Raikkonen 5th. It was a pretty difficult qualifying and the result is far from ideal. I struggled to put a decent lap together. I was lacking grip and made mistakes here and there. In some moments it felt good, in others not so. It was very easy to make a mistake. Every time I tried to push a bit more, the front end seemed to lock up, especially in the last sector. In Q3 I'd only tried to get a lap time without any big issues, to be able to get somewhere, but I knew I was slow. Tomorrow is another day, I'm sure it will be better. It's hard to predict what will happen, but as long as we get a good feeling and the tires are working well, we should be okay. Hopefully we'll make a good start and then see what happens in the straight and in the first corner. We'll try to stay out of trouble and be in a strong position after that. Force India Esteban Ocon 6th. It was an awesome qualifying session. I'm really happy. The car was not so easy to drive yesterday, but the team did an amazing job overnight to find some more performance. Everybody at the track and back at the factory worked hard to make some improvements and I could really feel the difference today. They gave me a really strong car and during the session the pace just got better and better. I actually made a small mistake on my final lap in Q3, so maybe I could have been even faster and ahead of Raikkonen. Even so, I'm really pleased with this result and excited for the race. We have strong race pace, good top speed and the potential is there for a very strong result. Sergio Perez 10th today. Hasn't gone as I was hoping and that's very disappointing. We have been very competitive all weekend, but we couldn't achieve the result we wanted at the most important moment. I was quite satisfied in Q1 and our pace showed a lot of promise, but as the conditions changed we weren't able to respond. We changed our tire warm-up routine and I lost all my feeling with the car. Getting the tires in the right window was difficult and I was unhappy with the balance. It's something we will need to analyze tonight. Tomorrow's race will be challenging, but our car has very good pace. I want to give my fans something to celebrate all weekend. I have received an incredible amount of support and today they deserved a lot more. I was happy to be able to speak to all of them at the start of the session and I hope we can give them a better result tomorrow. Williams Felipe Massa 11th. I did the best lap I could in the car. It was almost a perfect lap. Unfortunately, it wasn't enough to get to Q3. I was happy with my lap. Maybe 11th is better than 10th with the clean side of the track and new tires. Let's concentrate on the race tomorrow and see what we can get. We are in the fight and that's the most important thing. Lance Stroll 12th at wasn't a perfect job. Q1 was okay, and then in Q2 the first run was good at the start of the lap but then there were the yellows. Then, on the next run I just couldn't get the tires ready and I made many mistakes and didn't really set a lap time. I got in a lap at the end, but I think it would have been very difficult to get into Q3. We are starting 12th, it is a long race tomorrow, we are in the middle and I think we can score points. We just have to sort out a few things and have a good race. It will be tough for everyone with the altitude. Paddy Lowe, Chief Technical Officer. We knew from the running in FP3 this morning that it was going to be very tight to get into Q3 with the Renaults and Force India's looking particularly quick relative to our pace, and so it proved to be. We had good runs in Q1 and got safely into Q2 with both cars with 2 runs each. Unfortunately, our first run with both cars in Q2 was disrupted by yellow flags because of Hartley, so we aborted. We went out and had only 1 attempt in Q2 which got us P11 and P12. I'm happy with those positions considering how tight it is. We have a free choice of tire and I think our race pace may play in our favor relative to the cars ahead. We're definitely in the hunt to score points with both cars in the race tomorrow. McLaren photo by Clive Mason. Getty image. Stoffel Van Dorn 15th. We're taking penalties this weekend so our focus today was preparing for the race and definitely not on qualifying. Even in Q1 I was running on high fuel to prepare for the race and fine-tune the balance. After the struggles I had with the engine yesterday in FP1 and FP2 which made it a very difficult and complicated day today, I felt a lot more comfortable in the car from the first moment of FP3, and actually our package is getting stronger and looks reasonably competitive here. Today was a lot more positive for me and a big step forward, and I feel like we're in a decent shape for the race tomorrow. We'll be starting from the back so it will be tough, and where we will finish is hard to say. Overtaking in a straight line will be difficult for us, so we'll have to be aggressive, thoughtful and ambitious in the way we drive, and hopefully we can have a strong race. Qualifying was never really a priority for us today, so I'm looking forward to the race. Fernando Alonso 14th. I'm extremely happy with the performance of the car so far this weekend. It felt great yesterday and also today, with a lot of grip in the corners, and it gave me some good feelings in the high-speed sections, too. In Q1 we proved how strong we are on this track. Being only 0.2 off the fastest time shows what a great job McLaren is doing. I felt we had the best car out there today. It was good fun. Obviously saving some tires in Q2 was the main priority today. With the straight line deficit we have here, it's going to be difficult to overtake tomorrow, which is the key point for us. The penalty will hurt massively because starting last we will run behind traffic for the whole race, but we'll try to be aggressive and if something happens in front of us we'll take the chance. Eric Boullier, McLaren Honda Racing Director. Today's running was all about preparation for tomorrow. Since both drivers have sizable grid penalties this weekend, it made much more sense for us to focus on race setup, saving engine mileage and valuable tires in the process as we look ahead to what, statistically speaking, is one of the more challenging races on the calendar for us. I'd like to praise the team for a very efficient and productive FP3, and a perfectly executed qualifying session that went completely according to plan. This morning, we managed to complete everything we had planned with no problems, and both drivers worked hard to dial in their cars for the race. The team has worked tirelessly overnight to improve the setup in preparation for tomorrow, and Fernando and Stoffel both felt happier and more comfortable in the car than at any point during the weekend so far. In qualifying, Fernando put in a monster lap to set the fifth fastest time in Q1, which was only 0.2 off P1 in that session. His second sector was the fastest of any car out there. For Stoffel, it was essential that he completed as much race preparation as possible given his limited mileage on Friday, and he drove solidly despite the higher-than-normal fuel load to get through to Q2 on this tricky circuit. For both drivers, qualifying positions were not what we were aiming for today. Tomorrow is the day that matters, and the pace we've shown today is encouraging for tomorrow's race. Toro Rosso Brendan Hartley 13th. Today was a little bit frustrating. I'm a bit disappointed as IDNT get to put everything on the line, and I think we had a chance to be fairly up the pack. To be ahead of the Williams was definitely on the cards today. Breaking into turn 1 in Q2 I felt like it was spot on and I was pumped up for the lap, when the engine went bang. I don't know what happened, my confidence has been building all the time, lap after lap, and I was really looking forward to Q2 to really give it a crack. I'm feeling better and better in the car, and if Austin was a tough ask, I've come here a lot more prepared, that's for sure. Mexico's a track I really enjoy and I will give it all tomorrow to have the best possible race. Pierre Gasly 20th. I've spent way too much time with the engineers on the pit wall this weekend. There is nothing we can do really. We changed the engine last night after the issue in FP2, then again after FP3, and we didn't have the time to do qualifying. It's a new track for me and I would have really liked to have pushed in to see how it drives because I've never driven with the ultrasofts. It's been a really strange weekend. It's really tough because the only thing I want is to drive and do laps with the car to get used to it, get more comfortable and learn the track as well. For sure we don't feel really prepared, the first time he'll be pushing on track will be lap 1 tomorrow, but that's how it is and I'm not going to change the approach. He'll keep working with the guys tonight and tomorrow to be ready for the race. Jonathan Edwards, Chief Race Engineer. We thought yesterday was a difficult day, but today was no better with a number of issues on the poo side. Unfortunately for Pierre, at the start of his first timed lap in FP3 we had a turbo failure which meant that was the end of his session. We got the car back and we tried to repair it, but we realized it was more extensive than we first thought. In the end we needed to take a complete poo, however due to parts limitations the fresh poo wasn't fully built, so we didn't get the car out in time for qualifying. That meant the end of Pierre's day. Brendan had a really good FP3. We learned a lot about the tires and he was still building up himself lap by lap. By the end of FP3 he was really comfortable how the tires were operating and what was required to extract the maximum performance. We went into qualifying with good expectations and I think he showed that the car was very capable, especially in Q1. In Q2 he was building on that even further and it was looking like we were going to challenger potentially be in front of the Williams, but then unfortunately another turbo failure on the poo side cut his qualifying short. It was a challenging day. We need to understand tonight why so many power units are dying on our chassis. Unfortunately, it looks like tomorrow will be a difficult day for us. However, we will put today behind us, look ahead to tomorrow, remain positive and try to benefit from any opportunity in the race. Haas Roman Grosjean 19th. We have had a tough weekend. We didn't run anything yesterday, so of course there's always performance there. I had a very poor outlap at the end with a lot of traffic, so there were a few tenths in hand, but nothing that would put us where we should be. There's no excuse. We've got a 2017 Ferrari engine, which is more powerful than the Sauber one. We'll need to work, and we'll need to find a way to make the car faster at the circuits where we need extra downforce. It's going to be 71 laps with a handful of a car to drive tomorrow. Anything is possible. I don't want to be super positive saying everything's going to be great, but you never know in the race. It's a tough circuit and cooling is a problem for everyone. Brakes are going to struggle. In Singapore, we were not supposed to score points and we did. There's always hope, but definitely it's going to be a tough one. Kevin Magnussen 18th. We had feared this weekend would be tough. We obviously weren't very quick in qualifying. This track is like our Achilles heel. It was kind of expected, but it's still disappointing. We just have to push on. The issues are a combination of things. I'd say with the air being so thin here, everyone has to cool their cars a lot more, open up their cooling on the brakes, engine, water, everything. When we do that, we don't have a very good top cooling when it's open. We lose out there, and it seems very bad this time. Hopefully we can stay in the fight tomorrow, and at least push and see what we can get. I hope our race pace is a bit better than our qualifying pace. Gunther Steiner, team principal. We've ended up where we were afraid to end up a few days ago. We knew we would struggle with the high altitude here with our aero setup. So, we were almost prepared for it, but it's never easy to swallow. We just need to get better. Renault Nico Hülkenberg 8th. It was a good qualifying. I got a really good lap at the end of Q3, so I'm very happy and satisfied about that. It's going to be a tight battle tomorrow, but we are going to push hard and do our best. Carlos Sainz 9th. This is a good day for myself and for the team. We continue our progress since Austin. I am very pleased. Qualifying was tricky, but we advanced a lot since yesterday and I was feeling a lot more confident with the car today. We are aiming to have a good race tomorrow. Sauber Pascal Wehrlein 17th. Overall, I am satisfied with my day. Although we had some issues with my car in FP3, the team was able to resolve them quickly, which let me complete a few laps in the morning. The qualifying session went rather well. My performance was continually improving, and I had a solid chance of getting into Q2. Unfortunately, I made a small error in Sector 1 on my final lap and did not make it. Nevertheless, this gives me confidence for tomorrow's race and I look forward to getting back in the car and giving everything I have. Marcus Ericsson 16th. It was a good day. We continued to build on the practice sessions from yesterday and took the right steps on the setup of the car to be more competitive. It was a good effort by the team as we managed to get the maximum out of the car in qualifying. I am also satisfied with my final lap in qualifying. It was a nice one, and it was not too far off of Q2. We go into tomorrow's race with a positive feeling. We use cookies to help make this website better, to improve our services and for advertising purposes. You can learn more about our use of cookies and change your browser settings in order to avoid cookies by clicking here. Otherwise, we'll assume you are okay to continue.